ICT 21 June paper 22 presentation. Let us do the presentation. Of course, we have the source files on the desktop. So this is 21 June paper 22. These are the source files. Let us do task 6 presentation, that is PowerPoint. You are going to create a short presentation. When they say presentation, then it is a PowerPoint because they may never say PowerPoint because it's a commercial name. Okay, so now it is PowerPoint. All slides must have consistent layout. The presentation consists of slides. They must be consistent. Consistent layout and formatting. Actually, I control the layout through what is called master slide. Okay, I will be using a master slide as instructed. Unless otherwise instructed, slides must be formatted to display a title and bulleted list. Okay, maybe there will be a title and bulleted list, or maybe there will be a title slide with only title and subtitle. Let us go through and see what is required. Create a presentation. When the exam asks me to create a presentation, I go to my work area. This is 21 June, paper 22. Okay, I go somewhere here and right click new, and then I choose Microsoft PowerPoint presentation. So I create a new empty presentation. So I click on it. It needs a name. Let's give it a name. Okay. Let's call it our own name. And then click on it once, and then click on it again, and now it opens. So now I have an empty presentation or an empty PowerPoint with no slides in here, no slides at all. Okay, now I need 6 slides from the file 2122rules.rtf. I can find this in the source files, this file, but I need to import this file as slides into my presentation. Be careful because this is such a simple task. When you like to import slides into your presentation using this file, j2122rules.rtf, go to your presentation. This is your presentation. And this button is called New Slide. Click on the lower part of it. So this is the lower part of new slide. And click on slides from outline. This is the method. Click on slides from outline, and then go to the desktop. The source file is 21 June paper 22, and the file is j2122rules.rtf. Okay. So if I click on it and I select insert, now I can see that I have 6 slides imported into my PowerPoint presentation. These slides have been already pre-written and stored in that file. Now, and I can see that all slides are of the layout title and some bullets. Title and some bullets. Okay, now I have achieved this. Place in the footer your name, center number, candidate number. I do this using the master slide. I don't prefer to use the header and footer of the PowerPoint. I just use the master slide. Let us go into the master slide and select the appropriate place in the footer to put my name, center number, candidate number. The footer must be displayed on all slides. I will show you how. So I do this using the master slide. Let us go to the master slide. If you want to go to the master slide, you click on view, and this is slide master. So when you go to the master slide, you click on view, And this button is called Slide Master. Look what do we have here? We have several master slides. Which one shall I use? I would like to use the master slide that will appear on all slides and all layouts of slides. I think I will use this. This is the parent master slide of all types of slides. If you don't use the big one, use this or that by mistake, probably your name will appear on some slides and not the other. You'd like to ensure your name is on all slides, will be on all slides, select that big master slide. It looks like this is the parent of all other masters. Okay, let us click on it. The exam is asking me to place in the footer your name, center number, candidate number. Okay. So you can put it anywhere here in any box. But these boxes, they do not work. Normally, they do not work. I prefer even not to make them work. I prefer to erase them. I prefer to highlight all those boxes and click on the button delete. I would prefer to get rid of them. But I want to put my name. Okay, if you want to put your name, after getting rid of all of them, insert a text box. Now you want to put your name. Insert a text box and draw that text box where you want your name. I want my name in the footer. Okay, so insert text box. I draw here a text box in the bottom left or in the middle or in the bottom right. It doesn't matter as long as the exam did not specify. So now I have a text box. I put in it my candidate details. That is my name, center number EG007, for example, candidate number 0001, for example. So now I have my name, center number, candidate number in a text box in the footer of the master slide, of the big master slide. I think my name will appear on all slides now, consistently in the same place. The footer must be displayed on all slides. Yes, I am ready for this. Because of this, I have used that big one. Okay, let us close the master slide and see. Let us close the master slide. Go to that menu, Slide Master, and close Master View. Close the master view. Now I am back to normal slides. See, my name is in the footer of all slides consistently in the same place. My name, center number, candidate number. Okay, I have achieved this. It is only worth one mark, but remember, it is very critical. If your name is not on every single slide, you will not be marked. Your slides will not be counted for you at all. So putting your name is very important. Okay, I have achieved this correctly. Let us go to step number 30. On the slide with the title transition, where is this slide with the title transition? Yeah, this one. So this is slide number 4. So go down to slide number 4. On the slide with the title transition, demote. What is meant by demote? We will do something like this. I think those three bulleted lists are demoted. Demote the last three bulleted items so they look like this. Competitors, and these three are called demoted. Let us try to do this. Yeah, here are the last three. Here are the last three with the same text as in the exam. I would like to demote those three. They look like this. We call this increase list level. This looks like a list inside a list. Okay, let me tell you about the button that will help me with all of this. This button. Highlight those last three bullet list items and click on that button. This button is called increase list level. So when I click on it, see, they rather look like this. Not exactly, but this is one step towards achieving this. They are demoted. This means they are moved a little bit to the right and their font size is a little bit decreased. So it looks like these items are coming out of this. Okay, what else? What else shall I do? I think this text is italic. You have to figure out because otherwise you lose marks. I think this text is italic. Okay, so highlight them again and click on that button, italic. What else? The bullet shape is not a circle, is not a bullet anymore. The bullet shape is a dash. Let us try to change the bullet shape to become a dash. As you see here, they are normal bullets. Okay, if you'd like to change the bullet shape, click on that arrow. Click on that arrow beside the button bullets and look for the required shape. Unfortunately, it's not there. Then you have to go to more detailed instructions. Go to that button so you can have more options. Go to that bullets and numbering. Not here. I think you need to go to that button, customize. Go to that customize button, and then you get a list of symbols. Look for a symbol with a dash. This one is okay. This one is okay. Any dash, I think it will work. I will use this because this is one of my recently used symbols. Use this. You can find it somewhere. It doesn't matter what kind of dash you are using. Any dash will do. Any dash will be fine. Okay, I will use this and click on okay. And click on OK. See, bullets now, they have a dash shaped bullets. I think I have achieved those two marks now. They are demoted, they are italic, and the bullet shape has been changed to a dash. Okay, let's go on. I think the question, the PowerPoint question is not so long. I think here we will do with a table, we will spend some effort with inserting and drawing and formatting a table, and then the presentation will finish. Okay, let's go to step 31. Change the layout of the slide with the title, common penalties to become a title and table. Let us see, common penalties. This one. This very last slide. I wanted something with a title and a table. Change the layout. Let us go to the menu layout. This is the menu layout. Don't use this button. This button inserts a new slide. Go to this button to change the layout of that existing slide. I would like a title and a table. I advise you to use that title and content, and the content will be a table. So let's change it to title and content. This is the title and this is the content. And among different types of contents, I can use this button to insert a table. Okay. Now I have a title and content. Okay. Create a table that contains 4 columns and 13 rows. Well, I can use this button. 4 columns and 13 rows. I can use this button, insert table. And I want four columns. So number of columns should be four. And 13 rows. So type here 13 and double check. Yeah, four columns and 13 rows. Okay, four columns and 13 rows and click okay. See all this table? I'm bored because the table is overlapping my name. Please move the table a little bit up. You are not allowed to have any kind of overlapping. Move the table a little bit up so that your name is visible. Okay. Copy the data from the file j2122table.csv and place this in the table. Let us go and open this file and copy and paste the data in it. J2122 table. I can find this in my source file, in my working area. So this is the file, J2122 table. Double click on it. It opens in Excel. It looks really messed up. So if you want to see it properly, I would recommend that you select all and double click between A and B, and this is called AutoFit. So select all, double click between A and B, and this is AutoFit. I think now I can see all the data in the table. Highlight them all. Remember, there are four columns. Yes, these are four columns. And 13 rows. Yes, these are 13 rows. I'm here down to row number 13. Okay, I highlight, I copy the data and go to the PowerPoint presentation. I put the pointer in here in the first cell in the table and I go to home and paste. Yeah, well, data has been copied. Data has been copied. I think there's still a lot of improvements that need to be done, but data has been copied. Okay, okay. Place this in the table I did. Format the table so that a plain table style is applied with no cell shading. All internal and external grid lines are displayed when printed. I would like to change the table style. I would like to change the style of the table to plain table with no cell shading. See, here I have a lot of cell shadings. Okay, okay. When you have a table, you have table tools. All what you want to do with tables will be in those two menus. So I have table tools. I have design and I have layout. Going to design, I can find table styles. This is very useful because if you choose the appropriate table style, if you choose the appropriate table style, I think I need this. This is the best style. Why? Because it has no shading and border lines are visible. Inner and outer border lines are visible and there are no shading. I think this is my favorite. This is my best choice. Let us click on it. Okay, okay, well done. Table has no shading and internal and grid, external grid lines are visible. I achieved both those with just one mouse click. Well, it is worth one mark. Okay, excellent. Let us go further. But before we go further, I think it would be more appropriate because this column is so full of text. These three columns are so empty. So I would rather make that column width smaller and that column also small and that column also small. And as you can see, now I have more space for this. Okay? Okay. So this is better. This is better. Maybe you think this is too much. Let's move this a little bit to here and move this a little bit to here and move this a little bit to here. Okay? Okay, excellent. Insert two rows as the first two rows of the table. I would like to insert two rows at the top of this. Okay, where can I find the button insert? Look for it. I would advise you to look for it in those two menus because everything that has to do with tables are here. Design or layout. Go to layout. I think this is insert row above. I think this is insert row above. Put the pointer in here in the top row and insert above. See, there is one line above. Another time, there are two lines above. But the point is, again, the table is overlapping my name. Well, you can resize now. You can resize now because it is getting out of the page. You have to resize. From this, make it a little bit shorter because I cannot overlap the title at the top. I cannot overlap the name at the bottom. So you can. Okay. Now I have two empty rows at the top of the table, exactly as required. Insert two new rows as the first two rows of the table. I have them, those two. Okay, enter text. Oh, then you need to copy. You need to type. Please type here, conduct. And as you can see, enter text and format. Rows one and two of the table, so they look like this. Before I start copying, I think some cells need merging. Some cells need merging. So, for example, if you type here, stop and go, and you type here time, and you type disqualification here, I think those above three rows need, those above three cells need merging to type in this, in them. Let us learn how to merge. Highlight these. I would like to merge. Can I find here something? Yes, here. Here, merge cells. Yeah, okay. Highlight these and click on that button. So when cells are merged, they are open together. Now you can write here, type of penalty. Now you can type here, type of penalty. And you need to type it by hand. You type it through the keyboard. You cannot copy and paste like what I'm doing because in the final exam, this will be paper. So copy, stop and go, copy here, stop and go, and copy here, time, copy here, time, and copy here, disqualification. Okay. I think here I also need to do a merge. I need to merge those two cells. So I write something that fills all that area. Okay, I have highlighted those two cells and go to layout. Again, merge cells. Again, merge cells. And type conduct. Type here using the keyboard, conduct. Okay. But it doesn't look like required. I think. Go to layout. I think this text, I need it to be centered horizontally and also centered vertically. So this text, go to the menu layout. So it is centered horizontally and centered vertically. Also, those cells. I need them centered horizontally and centered vertically. Maybe you think you need to make the font size a bit bigger, but I don't mind. I don't want to. I may for the whole table, but it's not that point. I made it this center horizontal and center vertical. I made these center horizontal and center vertical, and also the merging. See, this step carries 5 marks. I think what is left for me, I need to do shading. Those two rows need shading. They look shaded over here. So I highlight all of them. And then how can I shade? Keep looking in those two menus, design and layout, design. This is shading. Give them a bit of shading, some gray shading. This one. Yeah, excellent. Excellent. So I think I have achieved all those marks. I think. Okay, what else? Adjust column width so that data in column 1 is displayed on one line. Yeah, it is displayed on one. It looks too small, but I don't mind. Table fits on the slide with all data fully visible. I did that already. Within the slide, all data visible and no overlapping. I think it's okay. I think it's okay. Maybe these cells, the data in these cells are bold. Maybe they look bold. Okay. Okay. Okay, done. Save the presentation. I think I'm about to finish. Save the presentation. This is save. Print all slides in the presentation as handouts. 2 slides to the page. I have a presentation of 6 slides. I would like to print them as handouts. 2 slides to the page. Each slide filling half the page. So also you have options in printing. Let us go to print and adjust print options. This is print. Instead of printing full page slides like this, please select handouts 2 slides to the page. This is handouts 2 the slides to the page. I think this will be on 3 pages. There are 6 slides. Each page contains 2 slides. Each slide filling half of. Yeah, perfect. Let us print this handout. Make sure your name, center number, candidate number are on all slides. They are from the master slide. Let us print into PDF and print and give it the name printout 7 and save it into 21 June paper 22. Of course, in your final, you have to print it on paper, but now it's fine. Let us look at the printout. This is how it should appear. This is how it should be. 3 pages with 2 slides on every page. Your name is on. The table is there with no overlap. Everything looks nice. I think you have been able to achieve all the 13 marks for this exercise.